Hi, this video is on understanding risk and the risk management process. A risk is a potential problem that has not yet occurred. A problem that has already occurred is called by another name, that is an issue, and it's treated differently in software project planning. Risk management is a critical activity in software project planning and tracking. It includes identification, prioritization, and treatment of risks faced by the business. Risk management is performed at various levels like project level, program level, organization level, industry level, and even national and international level. Risk arises from a variety of perspectives like project failure, safety, security, legal liabilities, and so on. Now let us look at the risk management process. The first step in the process is risk identification. Risks are identified within the scope of the project. The next step in the risk management process is risk prioritization. And the last step in the risk management process is risk treatment. In risk identification, risks are identified within the scope of the project. Risks can be identified using a number of resources like project objectives, risk lists of previous projects, etc. For example, if certain areas of the system are unstable and those areas are being developed further in the current project, it should be listed as a risk. Next is risk prioritization. It is simple to prioritize a risk if the risk is understood correctly. There are two things, the risk impact and the risk probability. So you can give a rating of low, medium, or high to each one and multiply all of them to give you the risk index for every particular risk. When you add up the risk indices of each risk, then you get the overall risk index of the project, which indicates how risky or not risky the project is. Next is the risk treatment. So first is risk avoidance. For example, if there is a risk related to a new component, it is possible to postpone this development to a new release. This is a slightly uncommon risk treatment. Next is the risk transfer. If the risk is, for example, the compromise of system security, it is possible to hire a specialized company to perform the security testing and system hardening. Then the risk is transferred to the other company. Next is risk mitigation. This is the common risk treatment. The objective of risk mitigation is to reduce the risk impact or risk probability or both. For example, if the project team is new and does not have prior system knowledge, the risk mitigation treatment may be to have a knowledgeable team member join the team and train other people on the fly. The last is risk acceptance. Any risk that is not treated by any of these treatments has to be accepted. This happens when there is no viable mitigation available due to reasons such as cost or unavailability of risk mitigation. For example, if the test environment has only one server, risk acceptance means not building another server. If the existing server crashes, there will be downtime and it will be a real issue in the project.